Are you stuck on your next big idea? What if I told you Reddit holds the key to uncovering startup gold? The problem? Scrolling Reddit manually is a total time sink, and finding the right communities is like looking for a needle in a haystack. That's where GummySearch comes in. It's a tool that makes finding, validating, and acting on those golden ideas so much easier. Today, I'll show you how I use it to find niches, validate, pinpoint, and even brainstorm solutions, all in under 10 minutes. Let's dive in. So, first thing first, why Reddit? It's simple. Reddit is where unfiltered, honest discussions happen. People share what they love, what they hate, and what they need. But here's the thing, Reddit is huge. Without a tool like GummySearch, finding valuable subreddits and meaningful insights is overwhelming. The challenge? You can't just type good startup ideas into Reddit and hope for the best. This is where tools like GummySearch comes in. It's organize and analyze everything for you. So let me show you how. Okay, now let's actually use GummySearch for a real project. Like, let's see how it works. I'll just tap, go to my browser and enter the URL, GummySearch, and log in because I already got an account. And as a default, I will see these audiences tab, and there are three tabs: audiences, advanced search, and conversations. So the audiences is the major one. It grouped some segments of your targeted audiences or customers, and there are curated one, which is like GummySearch already created for you, and something that you can also create your own group. And also this one is really helpful to help you find the top subreddit group, and it can show you the largest one or the most active ones and also the growing ones. And one thing quite helpful is that you can select the size, which means that for really large groups, that there might be many noises. And I probably just select 10K to 100K to have a look. And if any topic about design, or be specific about product design, because I am a product designer, and let's see if there are any relevant topic or relevant subreddit about this group. Now I see, okay, this is probably really specific, and I actually can add it to the audience, to my designer group. Right, I will just add it for now because I missed this. Yeah, and I see there are 12K members, which is a good yeah. So this is the trending subreddits group and save the audiences. Now I will use this as an example. I want to understand this group, what is the trending topic, what are the things the designers are discussing. So I can just tap this group. It's already included many subreddits. And I can see, okay, here are the topics that people discuss. They discuss logo, they discuss feedback, and they discuss portfolio. And it's growing, okay? 14% growth in recent discussions. Could be interesting. And also, I can see themes. So from here, I can see some different things, like the requests, pain and anger. For example, if I tap pain and anger, I can see some pain points from designers that they're discussing. And if I tap specific topic, and it will just open all the discussions in details. So yeah, from here, for example, panic when designing, And here it shows this as a question and also a lot of discussions in this topic. I can jump in by tapping reply on Reddit. Use my own account to interact. And also advice request. This is also something we can see. From here is the summary, but also I can see some topics. And now I just want to have a look at a portfolio topic. And by tapping it, I will see people asking to review their portfolio, and they're asking, present portfolio and how to use it and how to get the case study, things like that, some topic about portfolio. Now I have this assumption that many designers, or most of the designers, especially those web designers and UX or product designers, they will need a portfolio website to showcase their case, their examples or case studies. And building portfolio take a lot of time. I wonder if people will consider to use a product or use a service to create your own portfolio. So I will see in the solution requests if there's some topic. And by tapping here, I can see, topic around portfolio. If I tap here, people asking, which website did you make your portfolio on? And what are some of your favorite portfolios? So topics about portfolios. And again, I tap here, I can check how other people discuss about this. And that would be super helpful. And also I can summary it. For example, for this topic, which website did you make your portfolio on? I can have a glance that from those 105 comments, what is the summary? And it can save me time to read those all comments. I'll just tap here, summarize, and see how it goes. So GummySearch would use AI feature to analyze it. And now I can see, people suggest Framer, Webflow, Squarespace, WordPress, UX Folio, custom solutions, other things. Really good. Now I have a glance. I can have a glance at those suggestions. And it's not just from some random guy. It's from the real people who's doing design jobs. And then they recommend this. Why people recommend Framer? Familiar with Figma and interactive capabilities, but also it's quite pricing. And there are some pinpoints. And now I have this question, will people pay to get their portfolio built by someone or by some tool? So basically I can see here is a tab, ask. I can ask them, I can ask within GummySearch, and GummySearch will search all the Reddit discussions and give me the answer. So here is my question. I already asked you this. Will you pay for someone to build your portfolio website? And now it can analyze 100 relevant submissions and give me the answer. And it can save me 64 minutes by reading those things. Amazing, right? I already got this. So let's just ask the question. And it takes some time to analyze in a few seconds, and it will give me the answer, I hope, now. Good. Now I got the answer. Will you pay for this? Based on the Reddit discussions, many designers prefer to create their own portfolio website using available tools and templates rather than paying for someone else to do it. Oh, no. And seems that as a no for this question. The approach is, but I want to understand why. So the approach is often due to cost considerations. So people think it costs a lot of money and the opportunity to gain experience. For instance, one user mentioned that it's common for agency to hire someone to design their website, but for juniors, it's good project to work on themselves to gain experience and save on expenses, which makes sense. Sounds like junior designers doesn't want to pay money for building their website portfolio, a portfolio website, and also want to practice it. So they can use those no-code platforms. Yeah, that's good. But now I want to, that makes sense. Junior designer doesn't have much money to spend on this, and they have time, they want to practice. But what about senior designers? Yeah, because my assumption is that senior designers are super busy. Myself, I have my portfolio website need to be updated since last year, but I haven't done that. And I don't have capacity, but I do have some budget. I'm happy to pay some money for someone if it can get things right. So yeah, and now I can ask this question, like, will busy senior designers pay for someone to build their portfolio website? Yeah, it also can analyze all the discussions. Now let's take a look and see how it works. Will busy senior designers pay for someone to build their portfolio website? Right, now I got the answer. Yeah. Based on the discussions from Reddit post, it seems that while some designers might consider paying for a portfolio website, many prefer to manage themselves. Okay. There also, and other users suggest using free platforms like Behance or Adobe Portfolio. And additionally, people mentioned that when lies. Okay, that's not relevant. So yeah, it seems that the answer is not enough for me to explore further, because so far from the validation point of view, junior designers probably not going to spend money. Senior designers, from here I think I can dig more. So yeah, and it's good, it's already saved me some time, because before I might just think about, okay, let's go for it, let's build MVP to test if it works. But now it feels that, okay, this is something I need to consider validate again. But yeah, this is how I use GummySearch on just a simple way to validate my idea. So there you have it, a simple way to go from research to idea using GummySearch. Start by finding your niche, dig into pain points, validate the gaps, and brainstorm a solution. It's like having a startup co-founder that works 24/7. If this was helpful, hit like and have a try on GummySearch yourself. And let me know what ideas you uncover in the comments. I'd love to hear about them. And I'll see you in the next video. Ciao.